guys, we're back for more Back to the Future of the Game. Last time we got a hat, and now we are going to talk to Grandpa. Talk to him first.
Need any help?
Never mind.
I need no help from you. I can put the budget myself.
Yeah? Who is it?
It's McFly!
Shh, I know!
Alright.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm throwing the subpoena.
You can't do that. You have to hand it to him.
I have to hand the subpoena to Arthur, not throw it. Someone's playing tricks on me.
Oh, well. Time to get. Hello. This way, across the street. All right. Hi. Remember us?
Well, well, look who's back. They say rats always return to the scene of the sinking ship. Get him, Matches.
Uh-oh. Like, what are you doing? Uh-oh.
Come down from there, you son of a... What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
No!
Make me angry, Smucko! Get down here and face the music! You can't get away that easy. Nobody puts one over on Kid Tannen and lives to tell about it! You're dead meat,
twerp! I don't want to record them right now.
Better start composing your epitaph now, because I'm gonna carve it into your face! In bullets! Get down here!
I don't want to record them right now.
You're only making it worse for yourself. The longer you stay up there, the longer I'm gonna take evacuating your guts.
Eviscerating.
Einstein, help!
Yeah, lay off. Get away from me, you crazy mutt.
Go away, dog. We're busy here. Go on, scram. Hey, where'd he go?
Can't find me. Ah, that's how you run. Back to the back to the hideout, our safe house. We go. Yay.
I don't think so. I don't think that would be interested in Arthur's hat. I don't think that would be interested in Arthur's hat.
Let me push the button.
I don't think that would be interested in Arthur's hat.
You suck. You suck. Finally.
What now?
What now? Oh. Be nice to me.
What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
It's Kid. Right away, boss! Where's Kid?
Time to give you the subpoena.
Arthur McFly?
Yeah?
Got something for you.
Thanks. A subpoena?
It's invisible.
Ordering you to appear in court and provide evidence in the investigation into...
Kid Tannen? Take it back!
There
you
go.
Get rid of it, Mr. McFly. Once you've been served, it's your duty to report to the court at the earliest possible time. Failure to do so could lead to a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest? But Kid'll kill me. Stupid, stupid Artie. Holy cats, what am I gonna do?
I suggest you avail yourself to the protection of the court.
Oh gosh, oh gosh.
Grandpa got served.
Oh, I hate doing stuff like that. But I won't have to much longer.
No?
Once we get that 190 proof alcohol and build my rocket drill, my future will be set and I'll be able to quit this crummy job.
Oh, right.
Ooh. Time to get some alcohol. Hello, lady.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Crockett. Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
What's the scoop?
I've heard rumors that something shady is going on at the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen. It's under new management, you know. And, oh, we mustn't jump to any conclusions, not till the facts are in. I hope to heaven it is just a rumor. That soup kitchen is the front line in the good fight. If it goes bad, what will happen to the Stay Sober Society? Not to mention all the charitable institutions that depend on me for soup deliveries.
You make soup deliveries?
You make hot soup deliveries?
It's one of my many small contributions to the good cause. Healthy bodies, healthy souls. Or so one hopes. I pick up barrels of hot soup at the kitchen, and I deliver them hither and thither. Hill Valley Orphanage, the St. Francis Xavier Ranch for Unwanted Children, Foggy Mountain Home for the Incurably Insane, Shady Acres Rest Home. Oh, I can barely keep track of them all. It's a very big job.
I can help.
Yeah, I can help you deliver soup. I donate a lot of time to charities.
Oh? Which ones?
The, Mario Brothers.
Ah, yes. The Italians do so many good works.
If you'll just fix it so I can pick up the barrels of soup.
Now hold your horses, let's not get over eager. I drive the soup cycle in this town, and I'm not about to turn it over to an upstart. But if you're well connected with the local charitable institutions...
Yeah?
You can let me know when they're running low on soup.
What's the Stay Sober Society?
You haven't heard of the SSS? They do the most marvelous work, taking hopeless drunken bums and turning them into former hopeless drunken bums. I'm one of the founding members. And not to say that I was ever, well, you know. Anyway, we've always met in the cellar of the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen, but for some reason the new managers don't want us down there, so we're stuck. We've got nowhere to meet.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
At the Brown residence.
The Brown residence?
You mean Judge Brown's place?
Yeah, I happen to be good friends with his son Emmett, and he's told me the judge would love to lend his place out for, you know, good causes like yours.
Really? Why, that's the most generous, public-spirited offer I've received in a month of Sundays. Please, tell your friend Emmett we accept. The meeting isn't due to start for a little while, so that'll give our people some time to set up.
I got a book.
Oh? Where?
To the soup kitchen! Here we go! Alright, walk back the other way. Cause controls. Where are you going? No! Bad, Marty. Bad. Go in the door. There. Jeez. Dumb 80s kid. Or dumb 80s teenager.
Hey, Q-Ball.
What?
The truck just arrived with a fresh shipment of, soup.
Soup? Soup?
Well, this is the regular soup, and this is the special soup.
Right. Special.
Special.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm spicing up the soup. It's my secret recipe.
Listen, this ain't the Savoy, and we ain't here to feed these bozos no fancy soup. The boss has got a business to rebuild, so knock off the goofing and mind your post.
All right, just try the soup. Well?
I can see why you want to keep this a secret.
More delivery, more soup delivery.
There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help.
Hey, can you? Come on, Emmett. There you are.
Huddle up, Emmett.
Huddle?
Just listen up for a second.
Yeah.
Emmett, I can't get into the door over there. Those tables are jamming it shut.
The door? So your plan is to just waltz in there and take a barrel of alcohol?
No, of course not. That would be stupid, right?
I'll say.
Still, I'd like to get that door open. I can't do anything from out here.
Well, it's a simple matter of physics. A lever, some sort of stop. Let me see what I can come up with. Eureka!
That was fast.
Emmett.
Yes?
Oh, that's interesting.
Just a little mechanical ingenuity. In the end, the door is open.
Yeah, good job. We'll score that hooch somehow.
I'll keep cogitating.
I hope Doc Jr.'s thingamabob holds out. Excuse me.
Yeah?
Can I have a bowl of soup?
We're a soup kitchen. What do you think?
What kind of soup is this? It tastes like...
Scrolle ribollita?
I was gonna say week-old cabbage.
Everyone's a critic. Look, all I got to work with is this two-bit soup in a barrel and spice rack that hadn't been restocked since the Coolidge administration. What do you think I should do to perk this slop up?
Let's see. Have you tried...
Chili powder.
Give the soup a little heat, maybe?
Why, is it getting cold?
No, I mean, like chili powder. Muy caliente.
Oh, bit of a tough guy, huh? Actually, I like it spicy too, but it's gotta be edible for the common folks.
Come on, a little dash isn't gonna kill anyone.
Aw, heck. You got moxie, kid. Let's spice it up a bit, shall we?
Doo-doo. Pipe. Hello. Can you hear me now?
Ah, Miss Strickland. Come for some more soup?
Come now, Mr. Donnelly. You know I wouldn't set one foot in this mockery of all that is good and decent if the poor of Hill Valley weren't so dependent on Mr. Tannen's overblown show of generosity.
Was that a yes?
Just give me the soup before I gag on the hypocrisy.
I'll tell the boss you said hello.
I'll just bet you will.
He hasn't noticed the thing going down.
Picked up the barrel of hooch. Now all I have to do is to get it from her somehow.
Still tastes terrible.
Emmett.
Yes?
Obviously, this kitchen isn't the speakeasy.
Indeed. This must be some sort of front meant to cleverly and legally obfuscate the existence of a hidden establishment of ill repute. Perhaps in the basement.
Right. That might explain the elevator. We'll score that hooch somehow.
I'll keep cogitating.
I know how to do it. Follow the lady. Edna! Edna! Give me the alcohol, Edna! I mean the soup.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Crockett. I'm afraid I haven't much time. The meeting of the Stay Sober Society is due to begin very soon.
I know a charity.
As a matter of fact, I do know a local charity that's running low on soup.
Oh? Who?
The Stay Sober Society.
That's right. They'll soon be gathering at the Brown Estate, and we haven't provided refreshments. I can't get over the generosity of your friend Emmett volunteering his father's house for our meeting.
Huh? Wait there! Sonny! What in the name of Thomas Alva Edison do you think you're doing?
Don't you get it? You need alcohol to run your drill, right? Those bootleggers at the soup kitchen won't let us get our hands on any of their hooch. But we can get Miss Strickland to pick it up for us and deliver it right to your door.
No, out of the question.
Why?
I can't just let strangers invade my parents' house. What do we know about these people?
They're sober. It says so right in the name.
Well, okay, but a pop needs his peace and quiet at the end of the day. This meeting is sure to be too noisy for him.
They'll be quiet. You'll be quiet, right?
Oh, yes! I play my tambourine very softly.
You hear that?
Yes, but...
But what?
But it's still impossible.
Okay, forget the whole thing. We don't have to test your rocket-powered drill tonight.
We don't?
No. I'll take the train back to Washington, and I'll tell the folks at the office to give the patent to Dr. McCoy.
Wait! You will instruct the members of the society to wipe their feet before they come inside.
Then you are Emmett Brown. I thought as much. You have such a righteous face. Edna Strickland, I don't know how to thank you
That's
for your generosity.
That's not creepy at all.
Pleased to meet you.
The feeling is mutual.
Yes. Foreshadowing.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
Now you worry too much, Emmett. Well, we've served the subpoena and gotten a barrel of booze delivered to your house. Looks like we're off to your lab to build your rocket drill. You do have a lab, right?
Okay. Oh, God. Coming up. This is going to be the hard part. Coming up.
Come on.
Doc! I'm off to get the rocket drill.
Good.
Come on, let's go.
Can I do this without messing up? I doubt it. But we're gonna find out.
Are you sure this is gonna work, Emmett?
Don't let the ramshackle nature of my laboratory fool you. If all goes according to plan, we'll soon be in possession of the most powerful rocket fuel known to man.
We
That's
will?
Great. How?
Well, it's very simple. This crankshaft induces a powerful direct current into the electrolysis chamber, producing hydrogen, which must be periodically released into the primary distillation barrel. While tending to the hydrogen, we'll also need to regularly sprinkle these shredded protein flakes into this aquarium of tuber bacteria to generate the necessary nitrogen to catalyze the reaction.
Cool.
Oh, hot! Extremely hot! The temperature of the reaction must be kept at a steady temperature of 623 degrees Kelvin by carefully pumping these bellows. Any questions?
Emmett? Why is there a brace of drunkards gathering on our lawn?
Sweet fancy Moses, it's my father!
So?
So, he doesn't know I'm engaging in acts of scientific exploration in here. He thinks this is where I go to pour through my law books.
Oh.
You're done with the action. I'll try to get rid of him.
What? Can't we just start over after he's gone?
It's too late. The reaction's already started. Don't worry. I'll try to help you out where I can.
But...
Emmett!
Oh, here we go.
Father!
Don't you father me, child.
Don't you have a release valve on your mouth somewhere? There is a flame inside me that cannot be quelled by your legalistic gobbledygook, father.
Okay.
Pressuring me to be something I'm not.
Yeah, heater's on. Very inconvenient right now.
Excellent. Now twist the valve there. Great. We're about a quarter of the way home.
Emmett, get back here!
Oops. You know who invented fire, Pop? I don't know either, but you can be damn sure it wasn't a lawyer. Won't you release me from your unattainable expectation? Should I honor your wishes? You treat me like common bacteria! Stop being such a crank! No idea what kind of pressure I'm under!
Ah, damn it. I messed up.
Listen to the words I'm emphasizing.
Don't you turn your back on me!
Ah! Stupid thing.
This isn't food for thought, Pop. It's cruel!
I messed up already, and I got a trophy for that one.
Why won't you release me from your unattainable expectations? The hotter you get, the more I know I'm right. Don't you have a release valve on your mouth somewhere?
Is that him or... I can't hear that's him or him. Oh, yes, it was him.
You call a room full of lawyers trapped in a burning building a good start. Halfway there.
Emmett!
Keep up the good work.
This is very convenient.
Galileo's rotations. Do you ever listen to yourself? No idea what kind of pressure I'm under.
Umbrons have been officers of the court since God's heavenly spark first gave rise to man, Emmett.
I know what's eating you, Father, but I wish you would go on a diet.
Pressure? You're a child. You don't know anything about pressure.
Lawyers are nothing but overblown bags of gas. Law may be your burning passion, Father, but it is not mine. Is it my fault if I don't get a spark out of laws and statutes?
Keep bellowing like that.
Almost there.
I could have gotten it if I hadn't messed up that one.
Coming, Father!
Stupid.
I strongly object to the current of this conversation, Father. What use is a microorganism for law? If it weren't for scientists, men like you would still be divining the future with sheep's bladders and goat g- You do.
Emmett, who are you talking to in there?
No one, Father.
Damn it.
Me to be something I'm not.
For sure.
Just another one of your staffers who spins around you like a top. Lawyers are nothing but a bunch of hot air. There, I said it. Really want to vent our dirty...
Hot.
Just pay attention to what I say.
Damn it! I'm not through with you yet.
Stupid fur.
I get a turn to talk, or is this going to be another monologue? How many times do I have to prove myself to you before I can shake your overbearing criticisms? If you don't like my performance at the courthouse, then fire me.
Oh, damn it! No.
I thought you were a scientist!
Emmett!
Why are you always bellowing at me? This may come as a shock to you, Pop, but not everyone wants to be a lawyer. Can't you see this is eating me up inside? You know who invented fire, Pop? I don't know either, but you can be damn sure it wasn't a lawyer. Why don't you go feed the ducks, Father? Are nothing but a bunch of hot air. There, I said it. Why must you always scatter condescension my way? Maybe I should just get struck by lightning. Would that make you happy? Stop getting so hot under the collar, Pop. I don't get to control my life just because you fed and clothed me for 17 years. weren't for scientists, men like you would still be divining the future with sheep's bladders and goat gizzards.
No, no. Oh, so
don't
close.
Touch anything until I tell you to.
Image.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I strongly object to the current of this conversation, Father. No idea what kind of pressure I'm under. Many times do I have to prove myself to you before I can shake your overbearing criticisms? Being such a crank. I don't know what's eating you, Father, but I wish you would go on a diet. Pressuring me to be something I'm not. I'm not just another one of your staffers who spins around you like a top.
Pressure.
Why must you always scatter a condescension my way?
No! No! Stupid controls!
Listen to the words I'm emphasizing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Shut up, Emmett.
You have a release valve on your mouth somewhere? Can't you see this is eating me up inside? Lawyers are nothing but overblown bags of gas. Oh, maybe your burning passion, Father, but it is not mine. Oh, what use is a microorganism for long? By Galileo's rotations, do you ever listen to yourself? You go feed the ducks, Father. There is a flame inside me that cannot be quelled by your legalistic gobbledygook, Father. Why won't you release me from your unattainable expectations?
Why?
What did you do?
Stupid freaking controls!
Want to vent our dirty laundry in public like this?
Yes, we do.
This may come as a shock to you, Pop, but not everyone wants to be a lawyer. The hotter you get, the more I know I'm right.
Fire. Yes, fire.
Maybe I should just get struck by lightning. Would that make you happy?
Yes.
If you don't like my performance at the courthouse, then fire me. Fault if I don't get a spark out of laws and statutes? They call room for lawyers.
God.
Just pay attention to what I say.
It's not yet, I'm freaking paying attention to what you're saying. But the controller is it?
One great thing ever generated by a lawyer. I don't get to control my life just because you fed and clothed me for 17 years. Always bellowing at me. This isn't food for thought, Pop. It's gruel. You know who invented fire, Pop? I don't know either, but you can be damn sure it wasn't a lawyer. I have no idea what kind of pressure I'm under.
Yes.
How should I honor your wishes? You treat me like common bacteria. If it weren't for scientists, men like you would still be divining the future with sheep's bladders and goat gizzards. The hotter you get, the more I know I'm right. You don't get to control my life just because you fed and clothed me for 17 years. I get a turn to talk, or is this going to be another monologue?
I'm afraid I have to
finally.
My soup's about to boil over.
What? This isn't over, young man.
Whew. Yes, it is.
Are you okay? You and your dad sounded...
Well, you get the trophy for that, but...
A long time ago. We... No!
What?
Yay, did it!
Eureka!
Eureka!
All you do is fuel up the old rocket power drill, and you and I can...
I can take it and go.
But don't you want to test it first?
No time. The last train for DC leaves in just a few minutes.
All right. You've got to get this baby to the U.S. Patent Office.
Exactly.
So tell me, Sonny, when can I expect to hear back from the patent office?
A month to 6 weeks.
Oh, in about, I'd say... I can't.
Huh?
Emmett, I'm not from the patent office.
Dad.
I don't understand.
I lied to you. But
stupid
Jimmy
Cricket
to.
Concert.
It was the only way I can get you to trust me. See, there's somebody who's in big trouble. Someone very important to me, to both of us. I can't tell you who, but I need to save him tonight. And I need your invention to do it. I'll get it back to you, I promise. And, Emmett, you're gonna be a great inventor.
Wait! Keep the throttle at about 8.
He trusts us. The fool.
Okay, Doc, I got the drill. Now let's get you out of here. Come on, start. Not supposed to be. Doc!
They're moving him to another facility for safekeeping. Oh, I better go get a quote from the police chief.
Oh.
Paddy wagon intercepted. Suspect slain. And they're still after him. How am I gonna rescue him now? At least the rocket part came out of this in one piece.
I want to borrow your bicycle. Thanks, Edna.
Right, I'm coming, Doc. Still in danger, Doc. I've got to get you out of here.
What's that?
I said you're still in danger.
Never mind. Get me out of here, and we'll talk later.
Sure. Little box. Front window.
What's he doing here? Yeah.
Nope. Damn it. Spare tire. I got a hubcap.
Keys, how do I get him? Kit Tannen's driving the truck.
Kit Tannen? That explains a lot.
Keys are on the dashboard, but I can't reach them.
You need a protraction appurtenance.
What?
A reach extender.
Don't worry, Doc. I'll get you out.
Be careful, Marty.
I'll be back.
I'll wait right here.
Gotta set up a distraction. Maybe not. I need a distraction.
Leave it to me. Hey, driver. You're driving too fast. Watch how you take those curves. What are you trying to do? Kill me?
Yes. I believe he is.
Not quick enough. Can you distract him again?
No problem. Hey, driver.
Yes. Come on. Antenna.
I don't know where you're taking me.
Yes, Dad.
Object to your tone of voice, and I find this seat distinctly uncomfortable. You have a pillow I can sit on? Hey, I'm talking to you, driver. Don't ignore me.
You! Thanks, Doc. I guess that's why they call you the Streak.
How did you know that?
I have my sources.
You know. All right. Uh-oh. Hubcap.
Eat lead, Sagan! Ow! Son of a bitch!
Thank you. I got a gun.
Doc, are you okay?
I'm fine.
Awesome.
I wonder what sorts of bizarre repercussions my younger self's invention of a flying bicycle will have on the timeline.
Did you know that would happen?
I had a suspicion. I never could keep those rockets from exploding.
Thanks for telling me now.
What do we do now?
Now we get back to 1986 before our interactions with the past inevitably cascade into a calamitous future. Where'd you leave Einstein?
Doc?
He's not in the pound, is he?
No, but I think we've got bigger problems right now.
Uh-oh.
Great Scott!
To be continued. Part 4 is over of the movie. Episode.
What's happening?
I don't know. We'll have to be careful not to run into ourselves.
Hey, fellas.
All right, McFly. Let's go see the boss.
History says Tanner will be arrested by a rookie cop by the name of Danny Parker.
I fear that nothing will save Hill Valley from descending into the fires of chaos and corruption.
Nothing is over until Kid Tanner says it's over.
Get Tanner. Rolling credits. So, awesome. So, hope you enjoyed Back to the Future Part 4 of the movie series, at least. It's about time. And it is about time that I finally got my Let's Play going. So, hope you enjoy. Stay tuned for more and enjoy the randomness. I'll be seeing ya.